Greetings from Kerala, India. St. Paula Modal Community Eramallur presents the joy of sharing the word of God and the reflection.
Holy Gospel according to St. Mark, chapter 10, verses 17 to 30. As he was setting out on a journey, a man ran up and knelt before him and asked him, "Good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?" Jesus said to him, "Why do you call me good? No one is good but God alone. You know the commandments. You shall not murder. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not bear false witness. You shall not defraud. Honor your father and mother." He said to him, "Teacher, I have kept all these since my youth." Jesus, looking at him, loved him and said, "You lack one thing. Go, sell what you own and give the money to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come, follow me." When he heard this, he was shocked and went away grieving, for he had many possessions. Then Jesus looked around and said to his disciples, "How hard it will be for those who have wealth to enter the kingdom of God." And the disciples were perplexed at these words. But Jesus said to them again, "Children, how hard it is to enter the kingdom of God. It is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for someone who is rich to enter the kingdom of God." They were greatly astounded and said to one another, "Then, who can be saved?" Jesus looked at them and said, "For mortals it is impossible, but not for God. For God all things are possible." Peter began to say to him, "Look, we have left everything and followed you." Jesus said, "Truly I tell you, there is no one who has left house or brothers or sisters or mother or father or children or fields for my sake and for the sake of the good news, who will not receive 100-fold now in this age, houses, brothers and sisters, mothers and children, and fields with persecutions, and in the age to come, eternal life." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Loving of Christ always demands a denial of possessions. It means to become poor. The person who asked Jesus the way to inherit the eternal life, Jesus answered that you have to leave everything. It is a challenge for him to leave the possessions what he had and to follow him. Most of the time, our life also facing this great difficulty to leave behind what we have the possessions, which means the status of life, authority, unnecessary talks and feelings, attachments, etc. When we remove whatever things that hindrance us in following Christ, we receive the greatest treasure, who is Jesus, the reason of all joy and the eternal life. The call is not simply an attraction. It should experience and live it. Looking from outside, we feel it is easy to step on, but the path to the God is a mixture of joy and sufferings. The needle or camel expresses the narrow or difficult path to walk, but when we reach the peak point or destination, we'll be full of happiness and joy. This happiness cannot be taken away from us. It is a treasure or great gift we are going to receive. We don't have to wait to get this happiness after death, but the promise of Jesus that the one who follows him joyfully in this world with these difficulties or sufferings will have the benefit not only the world to come, but here in this world too. So followers of Christ have to renounce all the worldly possession of life and embrace the heavenly possessions through this holy following of Christ.